Well, Europe is facing a sudden new surge of coronavirus cases, and now some countries are imposing tough new restrictions to limit the damage from this second wave. ABC News foreign correspondent Maggie Rooley joins me now from London with more. Good morning to you, Maggie.
Hey, Eva, good morning. Yeah, people in Paris this morning are waking up to the strictest lockdown they faced since June. Starting today, all bars are now closed. Groups are limited to just 6 people. And these new measures come as France says their ICUs are once again starting to fill up. Now, cities across Europe are scrambling to keep these rising cases in check. In Madrid, police are now controlling who can leave the city. It's limited to essential travel only. Here in the UK, we had 12,500 cases reported on Monday alone. And that's following a dramatic spike from over the weekend. Take a look at this chart. You can see the cases are hitting well above where we were at the height of the outbreak in May. Eva, we're also just learning that 16,000 of those cases from this weekend were actually from a week ago and had been lost due to a technical glitch. Now, that means that those 16,000 people were not put through proper contact tracing. Officials do want to know that the number is growing in part due to widespread testing, but we're unfortunately now also seeing a rise in the number of deaths, and that number is concerning enough that already more than a quarter of the UK is on some type of lockdown, and officials are threatening that London could be next. Now, Eva, we're also watching what's happening in Italy, and if you remember, they were the first country that was hit hard in Europe, and unlike some of these other countries, they've actually managed to keep their case numbers relatively low in comparison. Even so, they say they're being proactive right now. Already, masks are mandatory outside in places like Naples and Rome. And tomorrow, a vote is expected to make them mandatory inside and outside throughout the entire country. Definitely something to watch. See if that mask mandate helps them keep their numbers low, Eva.
Now, the whole world seeing this surge. And as Europe battles the second wave, Madame Tussauds in London made an update to one of its famous figures. What can you tell us about that?
Eva, you have to take a look at this tweet that they sent out. This is from their London outpost. You know they're well known for their wax figures. They've always had a wax figure of Trump. They decided to put a face mask on him today. And with that face mask, they tweeted out, they said just a kind reminder to have everyone who enters Madame Tussauds also wear their face mask. I think it's no surprise, though, the timing of this, obviously after that stunt that happened last night at the White House. It seems like they're sending a pretty clear message on mask wearing, Eva.
Yes, it seems like they are making a direct message about the fact that they want people to wear those masks. Maggie Rooley for us in London. Thank you so much, Maggie.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.